I am Aparna Bhagwat and I'm a postgraduate student of furniture and interior design from NID Ahmedabad. And prior to that, I have studied architecture from Pune University. Currently, I'm working in Bangalore. So today, I'm going to speak about street furniture and public furniture in the Indian context, such as railings, park benches, dustbins, etc., and how we all use it in our daily lives, intentionally or unintentionally. But before that, I would like to share a project that I did at NID. It was all about simple furniture design, and it inspired me to look into street furniture. Even after I finished it, I really wanted to study it further. So this project was all about designing simple furniture for any posture that we choose. I decided to work on postures in an outdoor scenario. So here are a few pictures from my research of how people use, you know, parks and gardens to sit. Or maybe if I were to make a phone call, how would I just lean on my car? So my aim was to design a multi-purpose seating for all these postures, which caters to every posture outside, maybe most of them. And it could, you know, go into a garden or a temple building or maybe outdoor canteen also. So after I did a lot of research on the postures, I realized that very often we use hands as our element to sit on. You know, we put our hands like that and put our pressure on the hands. So basically, I wanted to eliminate the hand as a design element and replace it with the support that I want to create around that posture. So one of my explorations was that seat that you see on top. There it was like a movable seat with a pivot where you can actually adjust the backrest according to your convenience. But I realized this won't work in an outdoor scenario because it's movable. So it's prone to damage actually. It's very prone to damage, so it won't work in an outdoor scenario. So I decided to, but it really helped me in fixing the angle of my seat. I decided to come up with an elegant form, a very refined form, which replaces that seat. And I applied ergonomics to it. I came up I decided the lumbar support, etc. And the final form was the white one, which I was not very happy about because it looked very bitey to me. It looked very plain to me. It didn't have a play. And both physically and visually, it was very bulky. So I just added those grooves there in the less refined form. And it really helped me a lot in actually making it look much better and lighter. Then I asked a few of my friends to actually use it the way they would like to use it. And this is how they use it. You know, you can either sit on both the sides, or you can sit on the ground, lean on it, just read a book, or you can sit with your friend. And it's grounded into the ground. So it's a very rough, robust and tough seat. It can't be moved very easily from the base. So I had to also decide a few parameters that this seat must have. You know, it should be valley-proof, it should sustain the weather conditions, it should be very easy to clean, it should be very durable and very economical and easy to mass produce. So basically the final form is this, which was designed as a refined form to replace the mostly crude looking outdoor benches, and again it was designed to be mass produced. Now, coming back to where I started, it was during this research that I got fascinated with streetscapes, and I was very inspired to study it further because I think there is a large scope of improvement in the Indian streetscapes, the way I see it today. So here are a few of my observations. Here you can see this guy sitting on just a few concrete frames. Then we see these railings on this pathway, wherein, you know, people just go and just lean on it. So, or just you want to catch up with a friend. But actually this railing is actually not designed to lean on it, that's why it gets tilted. And it looks bad at the end of it. Then, suppose someone is very tired, but here we don't have a lot of street furniture on our pathways. So maybe people have to find ways like this to relax. This is just a simple solution for every day wherein, you know, you can just sit on outside a compound or stones to have a chai or a meal. when someone really wants to browse or something and you can't find anything, so you end up seeing another blank post. This was a picture where I was waiting for a bus with my friends in Bombay, and all I needed was just a ledge to sit on. I don't need a proper seat to sit. Then this is a park bench, which are taken. If you have noticed, there's a makeshift arrangement there. The concrete is actually falling off and there are bricks to prop it up. So this is how the street and the garden furniture is. You can see some dustbins which are completely spoiled. This penguin dustbin, you can see it for ages. It's very difficult to clean it. Very difficult to handle. It looks very crude with that crude looking stand. So now I would like to share a few ideas of how, if given a chance, I would like to redesign these things, you know, taking inspiration from our daily life, you know, how people are using all these things. So firstly, maybe, you know, these railings where people are just leaning, why can't we have railings which have a small ledge to just sit on? This won't protrude so much onto our pathway, but it's just enough for a person or a few people just come, sit there. Maybe we can have it, we don't have to have it at a length, but you could have it at some places where people could sit. You know, because in Bangalore, I've observed there's this Brigade Road where there are a lot of eateries, etc. So people just stand there, lean on the railing and then eat. Might as well provide something like this, or a structure like this, which is placed alternatively in between the railings when people can just relax. Or, you know, structures like these on our pathways, wherein people can just go and sit for some time if they have to catch up with the pen on the phone or they're just tired. Because again, it's inspired by this boy sitting on that branch. Maybe we could have very simplistic, minimalistic furniture like this, wherein, because we see a lot of misuse of the moment you create a bench, there's a lot of misuse, like people go and sleep there. To avoid all that misuse, maybe we can have very simplistic furniture which will be just enough to sit on. This is inspired by the postures that we see. A lot of old people I've seen in the gardens, in the parks, want to sit on the grass, but they are very tired after a point, they need a back rest. So this is something which can be made out of the naturally occurring stones. It could just be smoothened and you can just relax, you can just lean your back on it and move on. This is inspired by this posture. Then this is a bus stop wherein we see a lot of people sleeping at the bus stop during the daytime. So why not eliminate that completely? Why do we need seats? Because I've seen seats being stolen from the bus stop, the metal seats. They're stolen and sold in the scrap market. So why not have these two concrete ledges wherein one can be used to sit on and one can be used to put your leg on. And this is, I think, just enough for a person to wait for a bus for 20 minutes. Then this is a dustbin design wherein I thought, why not have a fixed structure for a dustbin? This is in concrete and metal. And why not use a recycled paper bag fixed on that ring to dump your garbage every day, and someone can pick it up the next day. You just have to remove the garbage bin and take it away. So it doesn't, it's vandal proof. It doesn't get spoiled very easily. It's a very fixed structure. So all my observations have led me to believe that there is an unseen and unmatched demand of public furniture from the general public, but no one talks about it, but everyone is using all these things that we have around. So I think being a designer, there is enough scope to redesign all these Indian streetscapes and provide public with better aesthetics and functional elements which are durable, sustainable and economical. Here I'm talking about concrete and a lot of metal. Because metal, A, it's recyclable, and even concrete nowadays, people have found ways of recycling it. The University of Singapore is actually recycling the concrete waste from demolition sites and making street furniture out of it, very interesting street furniture. So why not take inspiration from all of these? And also there is a new wood composite, which is 70% recycled hardwood and 30% non-toxic PVC. Which is very sturdy and which can be reused again, recycled again. So I think we can take inspiration from all of this and design better streetscapes. In conclusion, I think design is not just about aesthetics but also about functionality and usability. And I think we all deserve a very good design. So why not give something very minimalistic, very simple to a common man walking on the street? So that's my idea.